Hope you're having a wonderful Christmas break. I hope all the troubles that you had to face this year will come to an end soon, and 2021 will be a fantastic year. I know that I have missed going out, meeting friends, partying, going swimming, gym, all those things. But I'm hopeful that 2021 will bring everything back into our lives and it'll be more fun than 2020. This year I've been like trying to focus more on learning music. So I put together this PowerPoint presentation to explain some of the Carnatic music terminologies so that it'll be easy for some new beginner to get started. Let's go. So I wanted to explore talas and avartanas in this first slide. Tala is nothing but rhythm. So you always come across rhythm in your daily life, rhythm in your work, rhythm in your in the birds, rhythm in the nature, rhythm in the flow of water in the river, right? So every song has a rhythm. So you listen to any Kishore Kumar songs or any song, it has a pattern and a rhythm to it. Like for example, when you hear a song, you feel like you want to clap or you want to click like that. So you can even sing a song by clapping hands with it. For example, aane wala pal jaane wala hai, aane wala pal jaane wala hai, like that. So tala is basically capturing that rhythm using set patterns. And we'll go over that in detail. Akshara is just a note or a swaram. Sa, ri, ga, ma, pa, da, ni. Each one is an akshara. One note is sa or ri or ga or ma, like that. Some famous talas that you have come across are Aditala, Mishra Chapu, etc. Aditala is a 8 beat in one cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can even think of a simplest beat as 2 beats. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Or you can have a 1, 2, 3, 4 beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that. So you can have multiple different types of beats. Talas explore the different things that we need to learn in Carnatic music. Avartana is just a cycle of a tala. So we talked about this 1, 2, 3, 4. That's one cycle. Avartana is one cycle or one wave. Wave. And then second cycle is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that. So avartana is a cycle. And lot of avartanas in the wave becomes the song. Okay. You can also think of avartana as a measure in Carnatic, in the Western music. A measure is, if you look at this, there are bar lines here. So this is one measure. In one measure, you have some number of notes that you fit in. And you also have a time signature saying how many beats are there in this measure. It's a 3 beat or 4 beat, right? In our case, it's an 8 beat. Aditala is an 8 beat cycle. So you'll have one Aditala here, another Aditala here, another Aditala here, and like that. So you have 4 cycles there, 4 avartanas in that. Okay, each avartana is a measure. Okay, let's go on. So let's explore the concept of lagu, drutam, and anudrutam. Okay, lagu is having a symbol 1, drutam is having 0, and anudrutam is having U. Lagu is nothing but a clap with some finger counts, like that. Yeah. So drutam has 2 notes or 2 aksharas. It's a wave, clap and a wave. Turn your hands. Clap, turn your hands. Clap, turn your hands. That's the drutam. Anudrutam is just a clap. Anudrutam. Drutam, anudrutam. Lagu is, that's lagu. Okay. A lagu also is a important aspect of a tala. It also has something called jati or a family. So you have 5 fingers, right? You can count using just one finger or 1, 2 or 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So you have
so many five fingers, and it helps you counting. So you can have a laghu as 1, 2, 3. That's one laghu. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's a different type of laghu. So each one is a family. So if you have three beats, that's called tishra laghu. 1, 2, 3. That's 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is chatushra jati. Then mishram is a khandam is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And mishram is 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sankirnam is 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So why there is no 6 or 8 there, I have no idea. The people who come up with this format, they have to answer. Or maybe it is there, but I don't know the names for that. So here we are looking at 5 jatis with 3 beats, 4 beats, 5 beats, 7 beats, and 9 beats. 5 jatis are there for each laghu. Okay, let's move forward. So as we talked about jatis, tishra jati, chatushra jati, khanda jati, mishra jati, sankirna jati, based on the counts 3, 4, 5, 7, 9. And tala also has a jati. Every tala will have some jati. Okay, the jati determines the number of counts. Okay, there are 7 talas, sapta talas. Tala is nothing but a pattern, right? One pattern was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's called Adi Tala. Right? So, the pattern, the 7 patterns are Triputa Tala is having 1 laghu and 2 dhritams. Dhruva Tala has 1 laghu, 1 dhritam and 2 laghu, followed by 2 more laghus. So, 1, 0, 1, 1. Madhya Tala is 101, laghu, dhrutam and laghu again. Now what's the difference between Triputa Tala and Madhya Tala? It's just the patterns are different. When do you use this pattern versus that pattern? That we'll have to look in different songs and try to find the answer. I don't have the answer right at this point. Rupaka Tala is dhrutam followed by laghu. The only tala that has dhrutam first and laghu later is Rupaka Tala. Okay. Jampa Tala is laghu, anudrutam and adrutam. Eka Tala is just laghu. There is no drutam. It's the simplest. Eka Tala, just ek. Atta Tala, it's not ADA, it's ATA. It's laghu, laghu, drutam, drutam. Atta Tala is laghu, laghu, drutam, drutam. Okay. So there are 7 patterns, but I would say only 4 or 5 are really commonly used. Triputa Talam, Madhya Talam not so much. Rupaka Talam definitely. Eka Talam is pretty famous. Atta Talam is famous, and there are some Varnams that you have in the Atta Talam, like Viriboni Varnam, Vanajakshi Varnam in Riti Gaula, and all that they come in Atta Talam. So definitely Eka Talam, Atta Talam, Rupak is very famous, and Triputa Talam is also pretty famous. The rest of them not as much. So if you know these 4 talas, you probably can get along and sing as many songs as possible. So this table gives you the entire family of talas. So I said there are 7 talas, but there are 5 families or 5 jatis in each tala, right? 5 jatis. So 5 into 7 is 35 talas. So total there are 35 talas that we use in Carnatic music. If you do Dhruva Tala in Tishra Jati, Tishra Jati Dhruva Tala, how does it look like? 1, 2, 3, that's the laghu, right? Then Dhrutam, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That is Tishra Jati Dhruva Talam. Chatushra Jati, since there are 3 laghus, you add 1, 1, 1, so 3 more. So 14 beats in a cycle, Chatushra Jati. Khanda is 17. Madhya Tala is similarly like if you do 101, let's say Tishra Jati Madhya Talam. 1, 2, 3, that's Tishra Jati. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is Tishra Jati Madhya Talam. Like that, you have Chatushra Jati, Khanda Jati Madhya Talam, Mishra Jati Madhya Talam, Sankirna Jati Madhya Talam, so on. Rupak is having Dhritam and a laghu, right? So Dhritam 1, 2. If you do a Tishra Jati Rupak Talam, 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, three, four, five. So five beats are there. Like that, you can always figure out what is the number of beats in any talam by looking up this table, or you can do it in your own mind if you want. So Chatushra Jati Triputa Talam, the one that has eight here, that is the Adi Talam. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Adi Talam. Chatushra Jati Triputa Talam is also called Adi Talam. So Triputa Talam is pretty famous. We use it a lot. Atta Talam, again, Lagu Lagu Dhritam Dhritam. The Khanda Jati Atta Talam is pretty famous because we sing a lot of Varnams, Viriboni, Vanajakshi in Ritigala. So that goes as Khanda Jati is 5, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So Khanda Jati Atta Talam has 14 beats in a cycle. Eka Talam is the simplest, right? Tishra Jati Eka Talam, 1, 2, 3. Tishra Jati Eka Talam, 1, 2, 3, 4. Khanda Jati Eka Talam, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, Mishra Jati is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, like that's. Typically, you don't use Mishra Jati and Sankirna Jati as much. If you do come across Mishra Jati and Sankirna Jati songs, please put it in the comments and I would like to learn that as well. Well, Akshara and speed. Akshara is just a note, Sarigama Padanisa. Each one is a note, right? And you sing Aksharas in the Talam, right? Talam is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Adi Talam, each beat. Each one is a beat. In each beat, you can sing one akshara. Like, Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. So, that's a way of singing aksharas in the tala. And, Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Re Sa. So, that's a first beat. 2 to the power of 0. That is one akshara per beat. Second speed is 2 to the power of 1 or 2 aksharas per beat. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Re Sa. 2 aksharas per beat. 2 to the power 2, 4 aksharas per beat. That's the third speed. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Re Sa Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Re Sa. 4 beats. And you can guess what is the fourth speed. 2 to the power 3. That's 8. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa Sarigama Padanisa, Sanidama Magarisa. Sarigama Padanisa, Sanidama Magarisa. Like that. Sarigama Padanisa, Sanidama Magarisa. Sarigama Padanisa, Sanidama Magarisa. So that's a 4 speed. You can imagine what's 5th speed, right? 2 to the power 4, 16. 16 notes per beat. That's like really challenging your tongue and really challenging how fast you can say those 16 aksharas in one beat, okay? The next one is Gati or Nadai. So in a clock, you have seconds. Each second is exactly the same, right? If there's second number 1, second number 2, they are there for exact same time period, and that is a standard, scientific standard, right? Like that, if you're having a clock which is going through all the seconds and minutes and hours, they're very accurate. So each one is exactly equally spaced, okay, from the other. So they're very accurate. Like that, if I put a talam, say, let's say beat 1, beat 2, beat 3, beat 4, beat 5, beat 6, beat 7, beat 8, are they exactly aligned time wise? Like between beat 0, beat 1 and beat 2, beat 2 and beat 3, what is the time? Is it exactly 1 second, 2 seconds, 4 seconds, 8 seconds, what? That is the gati. Let's say I use 1 second between every beat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if I use 2 seconds in between each beat, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, like that. If I use three seconds, let's say 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that, right? And if I use 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. So, Nadai determines the pace. What is the counts you are going to use in between each beat? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, Tishra Nadai, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, Chatushra Nadai, like that. Mishra Nadai or Gati or Nadai, they are the same thing, okay? So they are important for spacing or spacing between the beats. Between each beat, what is the time? Are they exactly the same? They have to be exactly the same. You can't have beats which are non-spaced equally, right? You can't have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You saw that the beats are not equally spaced, and if the beats are not equally spaced, the song will not come correctly. The rhythm will go off, right? It will be off beat. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Kalai is the number of branches in a beat of a tala. So your tala is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So instead you can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's rendu kalai. That means you're squeezing two beats in one count. Or you can count it like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So it became double the count. 8, 8 into 2, right? So 16 it becomes. So that's a rendu kalai. You use rendu kalai for varnams. Most varnams are in rendu kalai. Sa, sa, mi, ni, ni, ye, ko, ri. So that's one cycle of varnam, Shankara varnam, Sami varnam, Sami ninne varnam. That's rendu kalai. I don't know if you said moonu kalai. I've never come across three kalais at all ever. So two kalais is all you use. In varnams you use them. Okay, so that concludes the some basic terminologies in Carnatic music and introduction to talam. In the next video I will demonstrate these talams using my sound labs mridangam machine that I have, and I'll upload that so that it will be useful for you guys to, you know, use the talams for different songs. Yeah, so hopefully it was a useful video. Please like, subscribe, share, and let me know your thoughts on these videos and what you like to see. And also, if you have some more things to add to what I said, please leave in the comments. And thank you all for your time listening to this, and see you soon, and hope you all have a great New Year celebration and a happy and joyous 2021. All right, take care, bye.